So we saw in the last video how you can get the IPL data from Kraggle. And looking around, there's this excellent article by the Cricket Savant, URL in the description below the video, where it shows the kind of stuff that you can do once you have the data. So here, you've got the various overs in a cricket match, and you can kind of see how the match is going. The blue line is the predicted score by the model, and the red line is the actual score. And you can see here that pretty rapidly it zooms in. So the model, even in the first few overs, has figured out that, oh, this match is gonna have a target of nearly 180. Well, if you just looked at the over rate, it's very volatile. It seems to go, oh, I think it's gonna be 170 if it goes at this rate. And then you have an over or two with few runs, and it crashes down to, oh, I think it's only gonna get 140. And it zooms up here. So it's all over the place. But using the machine learning model, he's getting a far more accurate projection. So he's never off by more than really 10, 15 runs, particularly if you wait till five or six overs, which you're supposed to do with Duckworth-Lewis. So basically wait for five or six overs, and the model does pretty well. He looks at a couple of models. So he does a multiple regression, he does random forests, and I think it was SVM. Oh no, nearest neighbor. Yeah. A nearest neighbor regressor. You can't, if you have a random forest model, you can't kind of go, oh, and the numbers are these three numbers. But basically, the nearest neighbor and random forest are the better models, like with the less volatility. But even using this, so he gives the fit, like what, where did it go, blah blah blah, there, here's the formula. The final score is the current score plus the 1.16 times the number of balls remaining minus 4.04 times the number of wickets taken plus 17.1. So this is like the Duckworth-Lewis calculator that we've been looking at before. And you can give it a go. You can just plug in those numbers to a match and see how well it does. You can also backtest, like the backtesting video we did the other day. I'll put that link in the description below the video as well. So then you can just look at the various IPL matches that have been played so far this year. Look at this. Oh, after the third ball in the seventh over, the score was this. There were this many balls left. There were this many wickets taken. So this predicted that the score would be 180. And then you can check to see, oh, in the end, the score was 184. You can experiment with this model and see, it is pretty good. So this is just the kind of thing that you can be thinking about. So once you have the data from Kaggle, you can load it up into either Python or whatever system you're using, and you can produce the various models that are available.